Michael, a church in Cincinnati, let me say a mega church in Cincinnati, announced on Sunday that they would be paying off $46 million in medical debt for over 45,000 families.
Wow.
The name of the church is called Crossroads Church, and they partnered with a medical debt relief nonprofit to wipe out debts for people in Ohio, Kentucky, Tennessee, and Indiana. All of the recipients will receive a bright yellow envelope, and inside the envelope, it will just clearly say, "Congratulations, your debt has been paid because someone loves you, and there is a God who has not forgotten about you."
Wow.
Isn't that amazing?
Wow.
Yes. And
that,
they also,
that ranks near the top of your good news stories.
It, yeah, does. It does. And it also, yeah, says that this deed constitutes the largest amount of medical debt eliminated in the nonprofit's history.
Wow.
Yes. Yes, Michael.
Yeah, thanks for that good news.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Well, in political news.
Yes, definitely.
Yeah.
In other local news, this past Thursday was one of the most beautiful days I've had this year. More than 100 people became homeowners at the Detroit Land Bank Authority's third annual buyback event. Participants purchased their homes with $1,000 down payment, and they're required to put $100 away each month into a savings account that will eventually pay their first property tax bill. The Detroit Land Bank Authority retains a reverter on the property until the individual meets all the conditions and requirements of the course. At the end of the program, participants receive the deed to their homes, and the money they saved in the form of a check will be used to pay their first property tax bill. The event was a huge success. And also, I was there as a volunteer notary public with the Wayne County Treasurer's Office.
Excellent.
It was an awesome event. And you know, I love what we're doing at the Detroit Land Bank Authority. We're bringing these
abandoned. One that I've been to has been more than 37 minutes.
Well, listen to this. The average church sermon in the United States is 37 minutes long, although the length differs significantly depending on the specific Christian tradition, according to a new research by Pew Center. Catholic sermons are amongst the shortest at an average of about 14 minutes, while sermons in historically black churches are the longest at an average of about 54 minutes.
For Biden to win the nomination.
I agree with you 100%. Well, on the lighter side of news, Michael, you know I love these feel-good stories, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you know, children are my absolute life. I worked in education for over 18 years. But here's a feel-good story coming out of Newburgh, Ohio. A little boy in Ohio received a standing ovation from his elementary school classmates after they learned he had beat cancer. Six-year-old, yes, he goes by the name J.O., had been battling leukemia for 3 years, and he received his final round of chemotherapy 2 days after Christmas. So guess what, Michael? When he returned to school, the entire school, his classmates, the custodian, even the lunchroom workers greeted him with cheers and applause as he walked down the hallway.
Wow.
He was diagnosed with acute leukemia back in 2016 when he was only 3 years old, and he spent 18 days in the hospital, underwent several surgeries, chemotherapy, and he is doing so well now, and we just want to thank him for being a strong hero and his classmates. This beautiful story, Michael.
Wow.
Yes.
Man, this just makes you just think about the strength and faith of even little children when they go through these illnesses and the surgeries and all that kind of stuff. And you think about how could you handle what they're going through?
Mm-hmm.
Man, what a hero. I like these good news stories.
Thank you,
good
Michael.
Man,
yes.
This is what
feeds my soul. Yes. I love stuff like this. So if anyone is interested in looking at the video to see the young fellow when he walks into school and everyone's congratulating him on his success with being cured from cancer, you can Google it and you can take a look at the video. His name is J.O. He goes by the initials J.O. and he beat leukemia. So just Google that and you'll see the video.
Wow. Wow, that's so great. That's
yes, great. Amazing.
All right, LaToya, church clothes weather this morning. Let's talk about this weather.
Wow, church clothes weather forecast. Today is Sunday, January 12th. We will be mostly cloudy today, scattered showers with a high of 30 degrees. Tomorrow is Monday. We will be mostly cloudy with a high of 43. On Tuesday, partly cloudy again with a high of 52. Michael, did you hear me?
Wow.
52.
Yes.
And then on Wednesday, we'll go back down to 39 degrees, partly cloudy. But for this morning, please be careful if you're going out. The roads are very slippery. I was afraid a few times coming in this morning, like,
yes.
Oh my goodness.
I had to make sure and keep the keep both hands on the steering wheel.
Don't accelerate real hard.
Right, don't go too fast because the freeways, let me tell you, all the roads are icy this morning.
Yes, so they are.
You know, and there are a lot of communities dealing with flooding. St. Clair Shores, some parts of the east side of Detroit, Dearborn Heights, Dearborn area. I don't know why, but every time there is heavy rains, there's